ओके
गुड मॉर्निंग
ओके टुडे बिफोर आई स्टार्ट आई वांट टू आस्क यू अ फ्यू क्वेश्चंस ओके नाउ
मैम
यस
नंबर मैम पेज नंबर
आई टोल्ड यू राइट नाउ डू नॉट ओपन योर बुक्स व्हेन यू हैव टू ओपन आई विल टेल यू ओके क्लोज योर बुक्स and sit straight in front. Okay children yes okay now I will ask I'm going to mute everyone and only the child only that person should open your mouth is that clear children yes okay now only the child whom I'm calling only they should unmute yourself the others please mute yourself even Shakti also okay
ma'am
yes
english grammar ma'am
yes english grammar please do not open your book now keep your book closed okay now I have Kritanya is there Kritanya
yes ma'am
yes Kritanya who is your best friend
Shamli ma'am
Shamli is your best friend. Very good. Why do you like Shamli?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, why do you like her? What do you like about her?
She'll play with me, ma'am.
She'll play with you then?
That's all, ma'am.
That's all, only because she plays with you, you like her. Yes?
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
Okay, fine. Next, Ali Bibina. Ali Bibina, can you unmute yourself? Okay. Ali Bibina, who is your best friend?
Rafael.
Rafael is your best friend. Okay. Why do you like Rafael?
He play.
He also will play with you. So your best friend, generally you like them because they play with you?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Fine. Do you have any other reason why you like Rafael?
Playing.
Only for playing.
Yes.
Okay. Fine. Okay. Fine. Okay. How many of you all watch cartoon?
Hi.
All of you all. Most of you all watch cartoon. Yes. Okay. I want you all to give me the reason why you all like to watch cartoon. What do you all like about the cartoon?
I like Shin-chan.
Okay, why do you like Shin-chan?
Because
it is comedy. Okay. Because it is funny. Okay. Anything else that you want to tell about the cartoon that you like?
Ma'am, I see ma'am. Motu Patlu, ma'am.
You like Motu Patlu. Why do you like Motu Patlu?
I like Doraemon, ma'am.
Gun?
I like Doraemon. Patlu? I see ma'am. Ma'am.
Yes?
I see ma'am.
Okay, those of you who said you like Doraemon, why do you like Doraemon?
Pizza.
Why do you like Doraemon?
Ma'am, what ma'am?
Yes, Jolly.
Sorry, ma. Can you say again?
Good morning, Allah.
Okay, you all are not clear. What you all are saying is not clear. Okay, for now we will take these two examples. Okay, some of you all said that you are.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. Please don't open your book now. I'll tell you which page number you have to open. Okay, just mute yourself and listen. Okay. I told you not to open the book now. Okay, I'll tell you when you have to open. Okay. Now just
good morning, ma'am.
What is happening in the class? Good morning, children. Okay. Now, some of you all said that you like to watch Shin Chan because it is funny, right? What are you all doing here? You all are describing what you like about Shin Chan, right? Because that particular cartoon is funny. It has so much of comedy in it. You all like the serial, right? Yes. Okay. And the girls over here, you all will like Barbie dolls. Girls like Barbie dolls, right? Why do you like Barbie doll? Because it is pretty.
Yes, ma'am.
It is beautiful. Yes. Okay, because of that you like. And boys will like to play cricket because it is interesting. Right? You like different cars. Because you get in different colors also. Okay, so here, comedy, funny. You have pretty. Okay. Pretty, all these words, what are they doing? They are describing what you like. Okay, they are describing what you like. For example, what is this?
Pouch.
It's a pouch. What color pouch is this?
Blue
color pouch. Blue. Very good. What is this?
Green.
It's green. Green. What color box is this?
Green.
Very good. Okay, so here, what are you all doing here? Okay, pouch. Pouch is the noun here, or the purse is the noun. Okay, and then you also name the box, right? Box is what color?
Good morning, miss.
Box is which color?
Green.
It was green color. Okay, so remember the words that you all have used. Okay,
that is the miss.
Tasmiya, please close your book and keep and just pay attention to what is being taught in the class. Okay, when you have to open your book, I will tell you. Okay, okay, children. Okay, now these words. Okay, comedy, funny, pretty, blue, green. What are these words? These words are called as describing words. You're describing an object. Okay, you're describing a noun. That is, these words are called as. What are these words called as?
Describing.
Very good. These words are called as describing words. Okay. Another name for describing words is adjectives. Okay. What is the other name for describing words? Adjectives. Very good. What is another word for adjectives?
Describing.
Very good. Another word for adjectives is describing words. Okay. Any word which gives you more information about an object or a noun is called as an adjective. Okay. Example. This is a blue pouch. This is a pouch, yes, but what it's giving more information. What color is this? It is blue in color.
Blue.
Okay, so the word blue is an adjective. Do you all understand what are adjectives, children? Yes. Okay, now shall we open our books and read? Okay, now I want you all to take your grammar book and turn your book to page number 29. Okay, turn your book to page number 29. Okay, this is unit 3, adjectives. Okay, now what are adjectives? Adjectives are nothing but describing words which describes a noun. Okay, it gives you more information about a noun. Now, before we start, we'll just brush up on what are nouns. Who can tell me what are nouns? What are nouns? Shamalin, can you tell me what are nouns?
Things.
Names of
things.
Very good. Naming words. Okay, anything which can be named are called as nouns. Example. Okay, nouns are nothing but anything which names a person, place, animal, or things. Okay, anything which names a person, place, animal, or thing are called as nouns. Okay, children. Now take your book and turn your book to page number 29. Okay. Unit 3 adjectives. Okay, Unit 3 adjectives. Read the sentences given below and note the words highlighted. First one, the cunning fox ran away with the small chicken. Okay. Okay. The cunning fox ran away with the small chicken. Second sentence, the clever tortoise defeated the proud hare. Okay, the clever tortoise defeated the proud hare. Okay, now in the first sentence, which is the nouns given here? Which are the two nouns that is given here? Which are the two nouns given here? Please unmute yourself. Yes, which are the two nouns?
Fox and chicken.
Fox and
chicken.
Chicken, very good. Fox and chicken. In the first sentence it is fox and chicken. What sort of a fox was it? What sort of a fox was it? It was a
cunning
fox. Very good. What sort of a chicken was this?
Running.
Small chicken.
Running.
Yes, the chicken was small, the fox was cunning. So the words here, cunning and small, are called as adjectives. Okay, they are giving you more information about the noun, that is a fox here, and over here it is the chicken. Same way in the second sentence, that what are the two animals that is given here?
Tortoise
was a clever tortoise, right? That is why it won the race. Whereas the hare was very proud. It was it thought that the tortoise anyway will come slowly only or take some rest and then go and finish the race, right? So what happened? The clever tortoise did not take any rest. It ran, completed the race, and it won the first prize. Right? So here the adjective used for the tortoise is clever, and the adjective used for the hare is proud. Okay, you will understand, children, what are adjectives? Yes, okay. Now, next one, we'll read what is given in the yellow box here. Fun to know, easy to understand. Okay, the words that are highlighted are called as describing words or adjectives. Okay, like I told you, it is describing the fox here, right? It is giving you more information about the fox. It was a cunning fox. Here, the chicken, how was the chicken? The chicken was a small one. Okay, so it is giving you more information about the noun. These words are called as adjectives. Anything which describes a noun is called as an adjective. Okay, they tell us more about naming words. What are naming words?
Noun.
Very good. Very good, Alina. Okay. Naming words are nothing but nouns. Okay. The word cunning tells us that the fox was cunning, and the word small tells us that the chicken was small. Okay. Small. Giving you more information about the nouns here. Okay. Next one. The word clever tells us that the tortoise was clever, and the word proud tells us that the hare was proud. Okay. So here the nouns given over here is tortoise and hare, and the adjectives or the describing words are clever and proud. Okay. Did you all understand what are adjectives?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Now turn your book to page number 30. Okay. Turn your book to page number 30. Underline the adjectives in the following sentences. You all know what are adjectives now, right? Adjectives are nothing but describing words. Okay, anything which gives you more information about a noun is called as an adjective. First sentence, the kind king looked after his subjects. So which is the adjective given here?
King.
Is the noun. So what sort of a king was he?
Kind.
Very good. Very good. The adjective given here is kind. Underline the word kind. Okay. K-I-N-D. Underline the word kind. Okay. Second sentence. Second sentence. The foolish shepherd could not control his sheep.
Foolish.
Very good. The second one is foolish. What sort of a shepherd was he? He was a foolish shepherd. So
foolish.
Foolish. Underline the word foolish.
Third one.
Which one?
Okay.
The happy children.
Next. Third one. The happy children watched the interesting match.
Happy.
Very good. Happy. Underline. Don't write. You just need to underline the word. Okay. Underline the word happy. There is another adjective given here. What sort of match was it?
Interesting.
Match.
Very good. Interesting. You will underline the word interesting as well. Underline the word interesting also. So in this third one, you have two adjectives given here. Okay, you have happy and interesting. Next, fourth one. I could not do the difficult sum.
Difficult.
Very good, Alina. The answer is difficult. Okay, underline the word difficult. Okay. But if a sum was it, it was a difficult sum. Okay, next, fifth one. The beautiful peacock walked proudly.
Beautiful.
Very good. Beautiful.
Beautiful.
Beautiful, and you have another word also. How did the peacock walk?
Proudly.
Proudly. Very good. So proudly also is an adjective. Proudly also is an adjective. Okay, underline both the words. Beautiful and proudly. Okay, next, sixth one. Young boy helped the old man to cross the busy street.
Young boy. Young boy.
Very good. Young boy. Very good. He said the old man. So old also is an adjective. And then one more person said, what sort of a street was it?
Old man.
Bushy. Yeah.
Busy. It is not bushy.
Bushy.
Busy, busy. S-Y, busy street. Okay, so you will underline the words busy young, street. Old, and busy. You have three adjectives given in the sixth through. Sentence. Okay? Next, seventh one. Father could not drive through the narrow lane. Very good. It is narrow. N-A-R-R-O-W. Underline the word narrow.
Narrow.
Okay, what sort of a lane was it? It was a narrow lane. Okay, it was very narrow. Okay, you have N-A-R-R-O-W towards the end of the sentence. Okay. Next one, the last sentence in this. Okay. There are colorful pictures in this magazine.
Colorful.
Colorful. Okay, underline the word. Colorful. C-O-L-O-U-R-F-U-L. Colorful. Okay, all of you have underlined these words.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Last one.
Last one is colorful. Okay, last one. Eighth one is colorful. C-O-L-O-U-R-F-U-L. Colorful. Okay, underline the word colorful.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Colorful.
Sixth one, you have three adjectives given there. It is young, old, and busy. Okay, sixth one is young. Old young boy helped the old man cross the
bridge. My M-A-G-A-Z.
Adun madilla.
Daddy, phone or there?
Okay.
Phone.
Shall I erase the board?
Yes.
Okay, next exercise now.
Excuse me, ma'am. No.
Yes, Ashwita, which one you're doing, ma'am?
Fourth one, ma'am.
Still in the fourth one. Okay, fourth one, you have to underline difficult. D-I-F-F-I-C-U-L-T. Difficult. Finish underlining?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, next. Fifth one, you have to underline beautiful. B-E-A-U-T-I-F-U-L. Underline the word beautiful. And the last word, proudly. Fifth one, you have two. Okay? Then sixth one, you have three. You have to underline young. Y-O-U-N-G, young. Then old, O-L-D, old. And then busy, B-U-S-Y, busy. Underline all the three words.
Fifth
one, beautiful and proudly.
Okay.
Okay. Sixth one, you have underlined all the three. Yes. Next, seventh one, you have to underline the word narrow. N-A-R-R-O-W. Okay, narrow.
I underlined, ma'am.
Eighth one also, have you underlined? Colorful?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
I finished everything, ma'am.
Okay, very good. Now we will do B. Okay, we will do fill in the blanks with suitable adjectives from the help box. You have the help box given here. Okay, you have the words popular, juicy, sick, naughty, clever,
brave,
cool, famous, bright, and pretty. These are the adjectives. You need to select the correct adjective and fill the blanks here. Okay. First one, the dash parrot flew away from the cage.
Clever.
Clever. Very good. Write the word clever in the first blank, right? Everyone should write along with me, okay? Right. C-L-E-V-E-R. Clever. The first blank, right? Clever. C-L-E-V-E-R. Clever.
See?
Shakti, have you written?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay, next. Second one, the dash soldiers faced the enemy boldly.
Brave.
Very good. Brave. B-R-A-V-E. Brave. Brave soldiers faced the enemy boldly.
Brave.
Okay, underline the word. Brave.
Yes, ma'am.
Brave. Next, third one. Dash sunshine gave grandma a headache.
Bright.
Okay, write the word. B-R-I-G-H-T. Bright.
Okay,
B-R-I-G-H-T, bright. Okay, next, fourth one. Rita wore a dash frock on her birthday.
Pretty.
Pretty. Very good. P-R-E-T-T-Y.
Warmer, why not?
Okay, right. P-R-E-T-T-Y.
Pretty.
Okay, pretty. P-R-E-T-T-Y. Pretty.
Ma'am. Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, Shakti.
Naughty boy. Naughty.
Second one, what, ma'am?
Second one is brave. Shakti, I asked you to finish. Brave. B-R-A-V-E. Brave. Okay, next, fifth one, Naaman is a dash boy.
Yeah.
Naughty boy.
Naughty.
Naughty boy.
Naughty.
N-A-U-G-H-T-Y. Naughty.
Master.
Right. N-A-U.
Naughty.
G-H-T-Y.
Naughty. Popular.
Okay, N-A-U-G-H-T-Y, naughty. Next, sixth one. Kalidasa was a dash poet.
Famous.
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 Another word. There's another word.
Popular.
Very popular. Good. Kalidasa was a popular.
Popular.
Okay, next, seventh one. The Taj Mahal is a dash monument.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Famous.
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 Right.
F-A-M-O-U-S.
Famous.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Sixth one is what, ma'am?
Sixth one is popular. Okay. Next, eighth one. I like to eat dash oranges.
Juicy.
Very good. Juicy. Right. J-U-I-C-Y. Juicy. J-U-I-C-Y. Juicy. J-U-I-C-Y. Juicy. Okay, next, last one. The dash man was admitted in the hospital.
Sick
man, very good. S-I-C-K, sick. The sick man was admitted in the hospital. Sick man was admitted in the hospital. Okay, all of you have finished. Okay, now we will go to the next page, page number 31. Yes, who is still writing? Yes, now page number 31, worksheet 2. Okay, you need to match the adjectives in column A with the opposite of the adjectives in column B. Okay, so in column A you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And in column B you have
column B.
Okay. Now, first one, clever. They have already matched with the opposite action. Foolish. They have already done this. The second one, obedient. What is the opposite of obedient?
Disobedient.
Very good. Disobedient, which is in G. Okay, write 2 next to disobedient. G.
Ma'am, what number, ma'am?
Page number 31.
What letter, ma'am?
Okay, page number 31. G. Next to G, you have to write 2. Okay, next to G, you have to write 2. Okay, next, third one, kind. Opposite of kind is
Cruel.
Cruel.
Cruel. Very good. That is cruel. I. Okay, the word cruel is given. Next to I, write three.
Cold hot.
Okay, next to I, write
three.
Next one, fourth one, cold. What is the opposite of cold?
Hot.
Hot. Hot. It is hot. What is B? B is hot. Okay, next. Fifth one, long. What is the opposite of long?
Short.
Very good. Short. Short is J. Okay. One short is given. Next is J. Write five there. Okay. Next one, narrow.
Broad.
Very good. So K is broad. Next to K, right? Six.
Broad.
Okay. The opposite of narrow is broad. Yes. The word broad is given here. K. Right? Six there. Okay. Next one, seventh one, bright. Next to C, write seven. Next one, brave. What is the opposite of brave?
Cover.
Very good. Covered. So here, write eight. Okay. Next to covered. Covered means someone who is very scared. Okay. So
man, man, not letter, man.
S. Next to S, right? Eight. Okay. Next one, beautiful. What is the opposite
ugly.
Of beautiful?
Ugly. Ugly.
Ugly. Very good. Ugly is given near D, right? Nine. Okay, D.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Ugly is given near D, right? Nine.
Zero. Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, Shakti.
Eighth one, not ma'am.
Eighth one, S. S is covered. S. Against S, right? Eight. Okay. All of you have finished. You're beautiful. Lovely. Next is one colorful.
Colorless.
You're right.
10. 11.
Okay, next to colorless, right? And that is A. Okay. Yes, Shakti.
I know, man.
Yes, not Shakti. Then who was that? Prithanya, tell me Prithanya.
Ugly man. Ugly man.
Ugly is seven. I'm sorry, nine. Ma, D. Ugly is D. Next to D, right? Nine. Okay. Then tenth one is colorful. Opposite of colorful is colorless. That is A. Next to A, right? Ten. Okay. And the last one.
Difficult.
Easy. Next to H, right? Next to H, right? 11. Okay, next to H, right? 11.
Yes.
Okay, just check your answers, children. Against A, you should have written 10. B is 4. C is 7. D is 9, D is 1, S is 8, G is 2, H is 11, I is 3, J is 5, and K is 6. Okay, all of you have written the numbers correctly?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, do you understand what we did till now, children?
Opposites.
Now we did opposites. What was the lesson that we did now? Adjectives. Very good. Adjectives. What is the other name for adjectives? Describing words. Very good. Okay, so all describing words. Whatever we've done till now.
Acting.
Tell us any doubt?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay. Time is also running. All of you have finished this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then we will wind up with the class, children. Thank you very much. Okay.
Bye and thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye bye.
Thank you.